Hello.
Hello. why do you sound like you're dead? How's it going, man?
Pretty good. How about you guys? I was watching the stream. Looks sounds pretty. Everything going pretty cool. Yeah.
Yeah. I saw you in the chat interacting with a couple of people. That's super fun. So hope you've been enjoying it.
People are literally so excited for you. They're like, Fred Grubb, cool, but Takoda's coming. I'm like, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
You're kind of the man.
Dude, people are so thrilled to see you back here. We got a couple people that have sent in donations to Give Kids the World so that you will say something in the voice for yes. them.
Right, yes, awesome. Yeah, I'm very excited, yeah.
I mean, it's been a while since you've done the parody voice, yeah?
A little bit, yeah. I was practicing the other day.
You were practicing?
Yeah,
and what were you saying?
Yeah, it's been a minute.
Were you saying, were you just going like from the park, from the rides?
yeah, I was going over some of the old ones. I was watching the Tempesto one the other day.
Oh my gosh, the dude, the first one.
It's been a while.
Dude, that's crazy. Yeah, people often ask what's going on with the parodies, and my answer to them always has been that the main thing, honestly, was this documentary that we were working on for the longest time. Mm-hmm. That I barely was able to work on like anything else other than that. That was like such a time span. I mean, as you know, just from years of doing it, the parodies they take quite a bit of time to do. We'll have them back. I know that I had a couple fun ones in mind. So hopefully into the new year we'll be able to get some good ones out. But
I'm excited.
I'm going to make my debut. I'm very excited about that.
Oh, yeah.
All right. So what are some of the things that...
First, before you say anything in the voice, people wanted to know if you missed doing the parodies and if you're excited for them to come back.
Yes and yes. Yeah, no, I miss them. I miss them a bunch. I was thinking about them a lot. I was like, dang, like, haven't done one in a long time. It was real fun while doing them, and then I get messages all the time. Everybody's always asking me about the parodies, you know, if they're coming back, am I working on anything or anything like that. So but yeah, I'm very excited to, you know, get back into it and start doing them again. You know, it was a lot of fun when I was doing them, and you know, very very excited to be back.
You're kind of a celebrity, so yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit.
Well, and people love it. I mean, it's so funny. I think back to when we first started doing it. I mean, you know, I remember asking you to do like, you know, like a couple that I just had like in mind, thinking it was just going to be like maybe one or two videos or something. And it really kind of turned into something special. I mean, did you have any idea what you were getting yourself into when I asked if you would do that?
Not really. Yeah, I just thought we were coming over to like hang out or something. Yeah, but then, yeah, we just started doing the parodies, and you know, I found the busted sunglasses, and you know, one thing led to another.
It got weird.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
That's so fun. Yeah, that's pretty much what happened. So, yeah, they were a lot of fun.
If you guys want to hear something with Takoda in it, we recently did a spoof of Victorious. If you watch Victorious growing up and you watch this video, you'll be like, holy crap, that is spot on. Takoda played Rex. Rex is actually right here.
Yeah, here's Rex.
I was not about to let Taylor get rid of Rex. So he's still here with us.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, and Takoda was a great Rex. It was a lot of fun. That was just a really fun video overall. Doing a fun spoof. Didn't Takoda, you say you had never even seen Victorious, and so you had to like look up
what?
A couple things in order to
I'd like been familiar with it, and I kind of knew about like the puppet guy and the main like actress from it, but yeah, I had to look it up and be like, oh no, what is this?
Hey, your impression was pretty good. I have to give it to you.
It was good. It was a lot of fun.
I don't know if it was quite as good as the cat impression, but I'm kidding.
Thank you.
I've been working on mine for a long time, though. You got yours done like overnight. I was very impressed.
Whenever you're ready.
For those who are unaware, a block zone is a section of ride that only one train may occupy at a time. At the end of a block zone, there is a method to stop the train. In case of the block zone ahead is still occupied, this is the safety system that prevents roller coaster trains from colliding with one another.
There it is.
Guys, we just had the ultimate El Toro Ryan Coaster Studios crossover that no one knew they needed, but we all did.
The guy where that quote comes from is was on earlier in the stream, so.
And he had to say that exactly.
Yeah, we made him say that, so now.
I think I might have missed that. That one might have gone over my head, but yeah.
No, people love it. That's a reference to a guy that was on the stream earlier, so. So,
oh, okay,
and you also cool. Just learned something new.
Biggest crossover. Yeah, that's great.
Taylor Bybee should go to the college football playoff game with Lucas next to Six Flags over Texas. Go to Cincinnati, beat Bama.
Yes, Lucas!
Oh my gosh, my friend just sent that in. He wants me to go to Six Flags over Texas with them, so he said to make Dakota.
Bro, I tried for you, and he's not doing it.
Oh my gosh, that is
great. I'll go with you.
University of Alabama, it seems.
I had no idea that he was going to send that in. That is hilarious. So I'm literally texting him right now, being like, bro.
Yo, Ryan said that was amazing. You're
awesome.
Blocked.
All right. I'm glad they like that, yeah.
Oh, right. Man.
Oh, this one's going to be tough. All right. Taylor Bybee is a pretty sussy imposter. This is kind of an epic Among Us moment. Thank you.
What does that even mean?
Why was... I just like to remind... Someone paid to have him say that.
I mean, you know what? Give kids the world. Why not?
It's for charity.
So whatever.
That's a good one.
Whatever encourages you guys to donate, I guess.
Jeez. Come on. Oh, man. That's funny.
It's about drive. It's about power. We stay hungry. We devour.
What does that even mean? Is that like a slogan for
is
something?
Is that does that mean something? What, are we missing something? Is that must be a reference.
It has to be, because it all rhymes.
That's a reference to The Rock, The Rock Johnson.
Oh! Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Apparently we live under a rock. Da-da-tsh.
Yeah.
We live under the rock.
Oh yeah, my goodness.
Yeah, that's what it's a reference to. Yeah.
Do we still have time with him? Yeah, we do. Okay. Well, even if we don't have any more quotes that people want to hear, which you guys still have time if you want to put any in.
If anyone sends any donations, we have a couple more minutes that if someone else has something, we can send it in. But, that was so funny. So...
Awesome,
in the meantime, reminiscing from past videos, did you have a favorite moment from...
I was going to ask that too.
from one of these, because we've done a lot of different parodies together, some dumb scenes, some funny stuff. Does any particular moment stand out in your mind?
Probably doing I guess because I was watching the other day, the first one, the Tempesto sauce skit, that was probably one of my favorites.
Okay.
I remember being in the writing room for that one, and kind of like kind of being there for the filming of that one. So I thought that one was funny.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's also cool seeing how much we were able to improve over time. Because I mean, did the first one. It must have been like 2015 or something. Were we juniors in high school, or when was that? Like. I honestly don't know.
That was
remember.
Like
or maybe,
a million years ago. That was like 5 years ago or something.
Yeah, maybe we were younger than that. I don't remember, honestly. But yeah, it's cool to see how everything kind of changed with improving over time and everything. we did get one more. I think Sarah just sent it to you over Facebook Messenger.
Yeah, someone wanted a shout out in the voice.
This is a shout out to Sebastian Freeman and Chris Kowalski.
Ooh,
like that. Well, Chris Kowalski and Sebastian Freeman
and
this is the next one that we missed.
I just got some more of them.
Shiver me timbers, my pants are full of macaroni.
Oh, here's one. Oh,
hold
on, I'm sending
it. Okay, here we go.
It's
so funny seeing what people come up with.
I know, y'all are weird as heck, but I love it.
What? Oh, man. All right, don't laugh at me if I get the pronunciation wrong on some of these. I'll do my best.
I think
it's Hoosier.
Yeah, it's Hoosier.
I already know that's right. It's Hoosier.
make sure to unsubscribe And now here are some of my hot takes. Hosier Hurricane is better than Steel Vengeance. Magnum is better than Maverick. And Raging Cajun is better than Sky Rush. Thank you.
Okay, but I would say that Magnum... Oh,
Magnum like, being better than Maverick is not that much of a hot take. Like, I feel like a lot of... There's a decent number of people that have that opinion.
I personally do not agree with that, but I'm sure people...
Yeah, there's a couple people there. Raging Cajun Takoda was a ride that was at Six Flags Great America in Chicago, but now it's at Six Flags America in DC.
I see. What was it? It wasn't a log flume, right?
No, it was like a wild mouse where it like spins.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I vaguely remember that one. I definitely didn't ride it when I was in when I was at Great America the times that I went, but No, I definitely remember seeing the sign for that one.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I was thinking about some of the fun memories, just random things that happened. One that stood out in my mind, really into Six Flags America. Do you remember when we went out to, we drove like 2.5 or 3 hours up to Six Flags America. We got there and nothing was open because of the cold. It was like
the
drop tower and like the loop, the Larson loop. And like, it was like the coldest I've ever been in my life.
You were going crazy. The cold was like getting into your brain or something.
Dude,
you were going crazy that day. I still have like some footage of that somewhere. I gotta get my hands on
it. It was
nutso.
It was so bad. I remember we went into the bathroom or something to like pour some like hot water on our hands because they were like frozen.
Yeah,
and it like scalded us because it was so bad.
Oh my gosh.
It was
like the little refugee spot or whatever. It was like from The Hateful Eight where everybody's shouting like, shut the door, shut the door.
I wish I got that reference. That movie is on my watch list. I'm going to get to it.
I got you.
I'll take your word for it.
It was very cold. It was very cold that night. I was surprised we even got to ride any rides at all. Very unique experience.
That was, and I kind of felt bad that that was your one experience that you got at that park, because definitely not ideal. We have time for one more thing that someone just sent in for.
I just sent it to you on Facebook Messenger. I'm sure you'll enjoy this one.
I got you. All right.
I have not heard this one.
Somebody's gonna use this as their YouTube outro. Nice, very clever. All right. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Post your comments on this video about your thoughts in this video. Do me a favor, give this video a big old thumbs up. If you'd like to see more, then make sure to subscribe.
I love you, whoever you are.
That someone actually sent that in. That was.
I made money for
that used to be the old outro.
I'm like OBS right now, and just going to use that as their channel intro.
Yeah.
I hope so.
Yeah, that was a. Oh, that was a time. That was like around the same time frame, maybe even earlier from when we like before we started doing Tempesto. I think it was, all before that. Like it was. Oh man, the videos have gotten better.
Oh really?
That's for sure. Yeah, that. Yeah, I used to say that. Like.
Oh, that's funny.
Then yeah,
I didn't even recognize. Oh.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, if you go back and watch some old videos, like maybe like 2014. That might have been it.
I'm giving this video a big old thumbs up.
Yeah, thank you.
Way throwback. Very cool.
Oh, my gosh. All right. Well, Takoda, this has been super fun. Thank you so much for coming on the stream. We really appreciate it. And we hope that you're doing well.
Thanks for having me. It was so much fun.
Yeah. No, of course. Yeah. And we'll talk soon. We'll get some parody stuff working on. That's for sure. I want to get them. Want to get them up for once we get into the new year. That'll be fun.
Awesome. Yeah, I can't wait.
Cool.
Thanks. Yeah. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for having me. I'll see you guys very soon.
Yeah. Thank you, man. All right. Yep. We'll talk to you later. All right. Bye.